The most important thing to do when preparing a talk is remember you know way more about your subject than anyone else. So you should never assume knowledge of the audience, and you should always pitch your talk at a level where you are sure that everyone will understand whether they're an expert or not. In terms of preparation, practice is everything. So make your talk well in advance, run through it multiple times, and if possible, present it to people who know nothing at all about what you work on, because they're the audience you're trying to capture. If you can explain it to your sister or to your best friend who works on a completely different subject, then you're hitting it about the right level. Practice also helps you with one of the most important things when actually presenting the talk, which is eye contact with the audience. No one wants to look at the back of your head. No one wants to watch you reading the slide. They want to look you in the eye as you're giving a talk. When you're preparing slides, keep them as simple and as clean as possible. Design is everything. Animations may look cool on your laptop, but you should only use them if they're really needed to accentuate the point that you're making. You don't want to distract the listeners from the words that you're saying. So by all means, when you're making slides, start out by putting a lot of text. But then as you develop your talk and refine it, you should be trimming that text out, so that you just have the main salient bullet points. If you have thousands of points on a dot plot, but you only care about 20 that have gone up or down significantly, put a big circle around those 20, put an arrow around those 20. Keeping time is obviously a critical thing. I use as a rule of thumb, roughly one slide per minute of talk. You might be slightly longer or shorter than that, but if you're giving a 10-minute talk, more than 10 slides is almost certainly too long. Try to minimize stress before you give your talk. So get your slides to the AV technicians well in advance of your session. Make sure that they are projecting and run through okay, so that you just don't have to worry about that. That's all taken care of. If you get the chance, go up to the podium before your session starts and familiarize yourself with the equipment. What button to press to change the slides, what button to press to make the laser pointer work. Use your laser pointer sparingly and just point out critical pieces of data to illustrate the point that you're making. Remember that the AV technicians are here to help you. So if you have a technical issue, if something's not working, stay calm. First, just try and calmly do it again. And then if you need help, if you need their attention, you can do this subtly, calmly, and someone will do something to help you. You should be aware of your audience while you're giving a talk. So sometimes you can be deep in one section of the slide, and if you're doing your job properly and looking around the audience, you can tell whether people are with you or not with you. So don't be afraid to adapt and make sure that everything is clearly across. People want to hear excitement in scientific talks, so don't be afraid to get wound up in the data. The more passion and the more information that you give, the more likely people are to remember your talk at the end of the day. Remember that crazy guy who waved his arms around. That's fine. As long as you're communicating your science in a way that everyone can understand, put every bit of passion and interest in it that you can. Answering questions after talks can be one of the most intimidating things about giving a talk, especially in a big conference with lots of people. One of the most important things to remember is make sure you let the questioner finish their question before you answer. Make sure you think about what question they're actually asking and not just present them with some pre-digested answer, and do your best to answer the question directly. No one likes politicians who never actually answer the question that they're given. Timing is everything. You don't want to overstay your welcome. So make sure you're aware of the traffic light system in front of you and the timing, and if it starts flashing yellow, that's the sign that you need to start wrapping up. Not that you need to go through all of the slides that you still have left at breakneck speed, but you really need to start wrapping up before it hits red and you're forced off the stage. If you've prepared well and practiced, it shouldn't be a problem, but always be aware of how much time you have left and be prepared to skip a few slides to get to the end.